Hello friends, in today's lecture we are going to learn about the BEKK GARCH model. In the previous lecture we have learned about the BEKK GARCH model and we have also learned how to write the covariance equation and the variance equation. Now in this lecture we are going to learn how to calculate the coefficients with the help of R Studio. So first of all, as we all are aware that R Studio are concerned with some packages. So to go with the BEKK GARCH model, we need one package for the multivariate time series. Now the question arises why we require the package for multivariate time series. So the answer is that we are already aware that BEKK GARCH model and DCC GARCH model are the model when we want to apply the multivariate. That means when we are going to study more than one variable, we use the multivariate time series analysis. So these two models, BEKK GARCH model and DCC GARCH model, tell us about the multivariate time series. That means whenever we have to study the spillover effect of one variable on the another variable, we are going to study either BEKK GARCH model or DCC model. So let's start with the library. So first of all, the package required, so I can say package required is MTS. That means multivariate time series package will be required. So you have to library it. So before doing it library, let me attach the file. I have attached the file of the share price. This is my file. So I am going to attach it first. So now I have attached the share price file. Now I will be library MTS package. So first of all, you have to install this package MTS and then you have to library this package. But before doing this package, you must be aware that whenever we are using this MTS package, with the help of this MTS package, this package can be run either on two variables or on three variables. If you are going to study more than three variables, then we have to go with some another package. We can't apply MTS package over here. So as we all are also aware that whenever we are studying the time series analysis, we have to first of all convert it into the stationary, and we all are aware that if we are doing the time series analysis, there are different ways to convert the series into the stationary. In this lecture, I have taken three stock indexes, N225 is for Japan, BVSP for Brazil, and SSCI is for China. So that means I am working on the stock price. I want to study the spillover effect of one index on the another. So I want to study the spillover effect of Japan index on Brazil, or I want to study the Japan index on Brazil and SSCI. Since this package can work either on two variables or on three variables, therefore I have taken this series where I have taken only the three variables. Now first of all, we have to convert it into stationary, as we all are aware that while converting we have to take the log. So let's convert it and write the command. Whenever we are using the MTS package, they automatically convert the series into the time series. That means they automatically convert it into the stationary. And the command is that first of all, let me create the return series. So I'll just give the name return is equals to. Now, command will be log. Now you have to give the file name. So my file name is share price, so I'll write share price and then bracket. Now after bracket you have to write comma. Now you will observe that I am not writing any word over here or any digit over here. I am just starting with comma. That means before comma I am putting blank. It means I have to take all the variables. If I have to take some specified variables or specified numbers, so then I have put some number over there. Now I am giving the command take all the variables or take all the digits, or you can say take all the observation. Now next command will be I have given the command that you have to take all the observation, but from where? If you will see this data, over here the first variable name is date, second is N225, third is BVSP, and fourth is SSCI. I don't want to see the spillover effect of date on N225 or date on BVSP. So that means the first column is of no use to me. So I'll start it with the second column. So I'll write 2. Over here, 2 represents your second column. That means I have to take all the observations from the second column. Now next command I have to give that from second column till what? If I want to see the spillover effect of N225 on BVSP, that means I have to take the till third column. So I'll write semicolon and then third. So now I am giving the command that take all the observations from second column till third column. And in this command, I am not taking fourth column because I don't want to study the effect of N225 on SSCI. After that, you have to add 1. Now you will see your series is here. Now let's give the command. Now next command will be, we are going to give the command that you have to run the BEKK GARCH model. So next command will be, let's say I'll give the name X is equals to BEKK11, and in bracket I have to write the return, that I am giving the command that I have converted this series, now use this series and apply the BEKK GARCH model. Now over here you can see this red button. Now once the red button, you will see that this red button is vanished, my output will be there. Till the red button is there, that means this R is working at the back end and they are going to give me the result. Now the question arises, till when this red button is there? Yes, it will take a few minutes to give you the data. So now you will observe that this red button is vanished, so that means here is our output. So till this red button, the red button over here will be there, that means R is working, so you have to wait. Now since in the last video I have talked that this BEKK model is based on log likelihood, so you can see in the output that it's given that it's based on log likelihood function. Now here is your output. So now what we have done, we are going to study the spillover effect of N225 on BVSP. So N225, that means Japan index, is my first variable and BVSP is my second variable. Now you can see, if I'll see my return series is this, that means they have converted into the stationary one. Now I'm going to see the effect. Now let's read this output, how we are going to write it. About the equation I have already discussed in the previous video. Now let's see how to write the output. Now as we have already discussed that whenever you are writing the equation and when there are the squared coefficient, the squared coefficient will always have the positive effect on the asset return variance in the next period. Now this is the output for the variance model. Now till now we have not learned about the output of the asymmetric model that we are going to study in the future videos. So let's study how to do it. Now A011, A021 and A022 are the coefficients of the constant term. Now let's move with this A11, A21, A12 and A22. Now if we are going to study these terms, now as we have also discussed in the previous video that it is very difficult to interpret it. So first of all, for the variance we are going to go with the B coefficient, that means B term. Now if you are going to study B11 and B22, I hope you all remember about the equation. And if you are going to study B11 and B2, so that means in the coefficient we have to study B11 multiply by B21. Now if you will see, B11 is positive and B21 is negative. That means if we are going to put B11 multiply by B22, that will be equals to, it will be positive is being multiplied by your negative term. So your answer will be negative. Now if you are going to see the negative term, now as we have also discussed that the negative term means that as we have already assumed that the positive 2 asset return, that means over here the 2 assets are your N225 and BVSP. The positive 2 asset return covariance, with which there will be an increase of 2 asset return covariance, but that increase will be very weakly decrease the next day return. So that means if in today's date there is an increase in the covariance, it's going to decrease the return in the next day. Now if we are going to study B12 and we are going to multiply B22, now you can see if B12 is your negative and B22 is positive, so your answer will be negative only. So again, if your answer is negative, it is saying that in the next period, the stock to return will slightly decrease. Now you have to remember, whenever we are talking about B11 and B21, we are talking about the first asset. And when we are talking about B12 and B22, we are talking about the second asset. Over here, my first asset is Japan and second asset is Brazil. That means first variable is Japan and second variable is Brazil. In this, we are saying that in Japan, the next day return will be decreased and the Brazil next day return will also be decreased. Now, let's move to the covariance. Now, let's see how we are going to study the covariance part. So, whenever we are going to study the covariance part, we have to see, the first thing we have to see A11 and A12. So let's write it A11 and A12. Now if you are going to study A11 and A12, A11 is positive and A12 is negative. That means if we are going to multiply these two coefficients, my answer will be negative. Now let's see what this negative term is going to represent. Now this negative term represents that your first variable, that is over here is Japan index, will have the negative effect on the next day's 2 asset return covariance. Now next we move to next term, that is your A21 and A22. Now if you are going to study A21 and A22, A21 is positive and A22 is also positive. That means my answer will be positive over here. Now, if you are going to see the positive term, it shows that your second asset, that means over here my second asset is a Brazil index, will have the positive effect on the 2 asset return covariance in the next period. Now, let's move towards the B term. If you are going to see B11 multiply by B12, B11 is positive and B12 is negative. So my answer is coming out to be negative. And if your answer is negative, it means that the increase in your return 1, that means the increase in the return of the Japan variance, has a negative effect on the next days of the 2 asset return covariance. Now if we are going to see B21 and B22, B21 is negative, B22 is positive, so your answer will be negative. So again, if your answer is coming out to be negative, it means that the variable second, that means over here the variable second is your Brazil return variance, have weakly decreased the next day's 2 return covariance. That means whatever is your next day return of the 2 covariance will be decreased. Now let's come to the next term that we are going to study over here. Next term that we are going to study is A12 multiply by A21 plus A11 multiply by A22. Now, if you are going to study these terms, if you are going to see A12, A12 is negative, A21 is positive. So, negative and positive means you are negative, and A11 is positive and A22 is positive. Now let's solve it. If you are going to solve it, your answer will become positive. You have to solve it. You have to write all the numbers and then solve it. Your answer will become positive. And when the answer is positive for the A term, it is not easy to interpret over here. So we are going to leave this term. Similarly, if we are going to solve B12 multiply by B21 plus B11 multiply by B22. Now let's see what is the answer for this. If you are going to solve it, take the coefficients of B12 multiplied with the coefficient of B21 plus coefficients of B11 multiplied by the coefficient of B22. Your answer will come out to be positive. Now, if your answer is positive, it means that the increase of the 2 asset return covariance strongly increases the next day's 2 asset return covariance. That means over here, the covariance of Brazil and the Japan index is going to increase in the next day. Now, similarly, you can do it for the 3 variable also. If you are going to do it for the 3 variables, what you have to do? Instead of this command, you have to write 2 is to 4. That means what we are giving the command, you have to take all the observations starting from the second variable till the fourth variable. And in this way, you can do the BEKK Garch model. That means you can study the spillover effect on more than one variable. But do remember that this MTS package is only available when you are going to solve or you going to study the multivariate analysis either on the 2 variables or on 3 variables. Hope you have understood the concept. Thank you.